So the largest tech show in North America, CES, is happening soon. And so I wanna go through some of the gear that I'm gonna be bringing to the show, as well as what you can expect from Think Media TV. Coming up. Hey, what's up guys? Sean here with Think Media TV, help you go further, faster in media. And on this channel, we do tech gear reviews as well as video gear reviews. So if you're new here, consider subscribing. And hey, at any point during the video, check out show notes and links in the description below. I'll list out all of the various gear I'm bringing to CES, plus some details about CES as well. Let's jump into the video. So my team and I are gonna be hitting the CES floor hard this year, looking for the latest and greatest tech to help content creators. So we're gonna have our eyes on cameras, mics, lighting, plus like smartphone accessories, anything, USB mics, tools for creators. That's what we're after. And our setup that we're bringing to shoot is two things. Number one, it's simple, and we're also trying to be extremely light, right? CES is huge. I've heard it said that you actually physically, if you spent 5 minutes at every booth, you couldn't even make it to every single booth during the entirety of the show because there's just so much going on. And so being nimble, knowing you're gonna be on your feet a lot, you're gonna be walking a lot, is one of the biggest things of CES. So the baseline shooter, number one, in our kit is gonna be this Canon 70D, right? That's our go-to camera. And one of the reasons we love it is just because of the autofocus, right? The Canon 70D, the 80D, some of the new Sonys. You really want that good autofocus during video so that you can lean on the camera to do that for you. This has been a shooter for a while. It's not really a new camera, but it works, it's dependable, and so I'm pumped to have that. On top of that, two main lenses. We're gonna have a wide angle lens, the 10 to 18, STM lens, as well as a 24 millimeter lens. And when those have STM, and the reason I love that is because that's a stepper motor that makes it work even better for autofocus if you use it on a Canon 70D or an 80D. And the wide angle lens is typically what we'd shoot with for just like the wide shots, the on camera shots, just like this one to kind of get that wide effect. And then what we use the 24 millimeter lens for is for the close-up shots of gear and some other B-roll like that. And what's cool about it is because the 70D is touchscreen, you can just touch focus really quick on the screen and make sure you're focused, you know, with that tack sharp, really crispy footage when you use the 24. So those are kind of our two main lenses. We're gonna have, but of course, a bunch of SD cards going. This is some 64 gigabyte SD cards. Make sure we have plenty of space and extra batteries, right? So that's critical. Next up is this Neewer 160 LED light. And what I love about this light is it can go right on top of your camera, just like this. And now you've got plenty of light in any situation. Sometimes the show floor can get dark and you definitely wanna be able to do that fill light for being on camera, as well as also illuminating some gear. There are definitely some very dark corners and places on the CES show floor. And so having a solid light like this is great. One of my favorite lights, I actually did a video about it, I'll link it up, because it's very, very affordable and you get a ton of light out of it. Also for lighting, I like to have a Lume Cube. And this is my favorite portable light because you can see how small it is, how portable it is. And we're gonna be doing some Facebook live streaming, some kind of on the fly stuff, you know, from mobile devices. And this is a nice light that someone can hold up if they're helping you film. And we also have some rigs, but to get some lighting on the fly, I mean, it can fit in your pocket. And so a great portable light stays within our theme of being ultra, you know, portable and very low weight. And one other thing that I forgot to mention is this cool little piece that gives you, that extends your hot shoes to two different hot shoes for your DSLR. So then what we do is we can put the LED light, it actually elevates it a little higher, which is nice. So you can almost get the lighting slightly elevated, not so head on at kind of that angle like that, yes. And then on here, we'll put the Rode VideoMic Pro. And so that's on the camera right now. And get a little bit of on-camera audio as well as backup audio in case for some reason the Zoom H1, you know, something happened with it. Now for audio, I just bring a Zoom H1. And the reason I like this is because it is very light and I can use it as an interview mic. And so at NAB and CES last year, this was still the mic. You could talk into it like this. You could hand it to somebody else to interview them. And again, it just works. These are super affordable, not very heavy. And we have heavier mics that have the wireless receivers and the packs and all these other kind of things. But those get kind of bulky and, you know, it's just not quite as simple as this. And what's nice about this too is using wireless at CES is kind of risky, especially if you don't have someone dedicated to monitoring the audio, just because other frequencies could be competing and whatnot. And so this is an external audio recorder. You can record, you know, like, hey, what's up guys? Or you could be narrating about products and things like that directly into this mic. The audio gets saved here on a separate, you know, micro SD card, and then just edit that together with the footage later. And so an ultra simple, ultra portable audio solution. For stabilization, I always like to throw in the Joby GorillaPod, just very versatile. We'll be able to use that for some mobile stuff that we'll do. I'll talk about that in a second, as well as whether it's on the DSLR or if we want to do some creative shots, you know, wrap this around poles and do like a team shot, whatever. This is just probably an essential piece of kit to have. And I'm also going to be bringing a Revelli tripod, which I love because it's super light and it also goes super tall. So I'm 6'1". Some tripods, you know, can only come up to here on me, right? So I like to have one that can extend higher so you can get, you know, good angles. And I'm also going to grab, hang on, our faithful Manfrotto monopod. Now, this video monopod is probably one of the main tools that we'll keep it on. We'll keep the Joby and the Revelli, you know, in the bag and maybe use those depending if the team's out shooting or whatever's happening with people. What's great about this is you get those steady shots, but it's very portable. CS is crowded, you know, setting up a tripod, it can sometimes be a little bit tough. And if you wanna just run and gun and shoot, this is your ideal tool. Roll in, set it down, and then you can get those panning product shots nice and easy. You get some stabilization for your pan shots. You could pan in with the video head here around different things like that. So this is typically the main stabilization solution that I like to use. Next up is a power bank. You wanna keep, of course, those mobile devices charged and have plenty of power with you. This one is by Aki. It's got the quick charge. It can charge up even like the Loom Cube, but definitely mainly for the phone. And then speaking of mobile, I'm gonna be bringing an iPhone 6S Plus to do some, of course, photos for Instagram, some live streaming. And for live streaming, we use the Mifoto Sidekick 360 Plus version, the one that'll fit the larger phone, as well as a Rode mic, Video Mic Mi, and so then you get that shotgun mic. And so now you've got a live stream solution that'll also connect up to, you know, this Joby right here. One sec. This is ridiculous. Got it. And so for having a little portable mobile setup, super nice. You've got the good audio with the Rode mic here, the Mifoto, and you can use this. I like to sometimes use it for stabilization, but on my using my body, just kind of take out some of the shake. You get some shots there. Obviously, you could set it up on a table or whatnot. And so that's kind of our mobile setup for CES. Now, one of the top things on my essentials to bring to CES is good shoes. And that's no joke at all. Last year, actually, I had some bad shoes and my feet kind of cramped up because we were walking, you know, like 8 to 10 hours a day on the floor after stuff that's happening before and after CES. And so for that, ASICS Gel 360s. And so I've tested out a lot of different shoes. I love these because you have gel all the way around. And you've got this comfort that will last for walking hours upon hours upon hours for multiple days in a row. So good shoes is definitely a huge tip. And I also like to have a point and shoot backup camera, as well as one that can just pull out and maybe shoot some B-roll, some great footage and shots. So this is a Canon PowerShot G7X. Two things that are great about it. One, you've got the good HD video that'll pair up pretty well with Canon 70D video footage. But you also have image stabilization that's really, really good on this camera. And so it's not too bad for just kind of panning some video B-roll shots, for having something that maybe everything is in the bag and you just wanna pull out and get a quick clip. You know, it can fit in your pocket. And so That's kind of a backup point and shoot as well. And all of that is just gonna go in this simple black backpack. It's actually CES policy. You can't bring roller bags of any kind. And so trying to think about how, you know, you don't want it to be too heavy and you wanna be able to have it last all day. And so this isn't too much stuff. Can fit nicely in here, as well as throw a few other essentials like maybe some food and you know, pens, things to write with, or whatever else you need for CES. So as far as what I'm super excited about at CES, definitely the Panasonic GH5. And so it's been announced, all the specs are out, and hopefully they're actually gonna have a model there that I can get my hands on. I believe that camera's dropping March 2017. And a lot of other smartphone accessories, cameras, drones, action cameras, I think USB microphones, other audio solutions, lots of cool tools for creators that I'm excited to get my hands on this year. But that brings me to the question of the day. What would you like to see covered at CES? What are you most excited about at CES? Let me know in the comments section. So thanks so much for checking out this video. Definitely subscribe for more videos just like this. And if you haven't downloaded the Think Media TV Video Gear Buyer's Guide, it's a complete guide where I list out all of my top recommendations for lighting, cameras, lenses, things like that. So you can grab that for free in the YouTube description or on the YouTube card. Until next time, Think Media TV is helping you go further, faster in media. Keep crushing it, and we will talk soon. Next up is our audio.
I'm having trouble connecting to the internet. Take a look at the help section in your Alexa app.
Now for audio, I just bring a Zoom H1. Now it's...
Sorry,